to be alive on a Monday night in Denver, Colorado, or what? Come on, let me hear you. We're celebrating, and I can't wait to get home to my lovely wife and my beautiful dog to celebrate, but I needed to make a pit stop here in Denver to celebrate with you. Show of hands, who saw Bash in Berlin? A strap match was hell, maybe one of the toughest matches I've ever been to, and I mean it when I say it. It is good to be alive and on the other side of something that was a very ugly and personal issue for me. And now that the personal is out of the way, guess what, Denver? We get to get down to business. Because that's what I am. I'm a business man. When I came back to the WWE, I said very famously, I'm not here to make friends. I'm here to make money. I'll take that money however I can get it. Cold hard cash, love from you, direct deposit. It's 1996 and I'm Patrick Waugh. I'll take it in gold. Speaking of Bash in Berlin, there is one other person that went through hell. Speaking of gold, there's one other person who had a tough battle and came out on top. That's right, I'm talking about you, Gunther. This is what I mean when we're talking about business. You put Randy Orton through hell. You took Randy Orton, one of the best to ever do it, to his limit, and then you went past it. Congratulations, you're the champ. Nothing can replace the chip on my shoulder other than that belt. I put Drew McIntyre to sleep, and it's time CM Punk woke up as champion. So Gunther, congratulations, champ. Enjoy it. Because we're gonna enjoy taking it off of you. The goal is gold. The target is Gunther. My name is... And we're gonna celebrate. Gunther, better get used to hearing Cult of Personality. Let's celebrate. Hit my music.
CM Punk feels like he's on top of the world right now, but has a new target wave as he calls out Gunther, the heavyweight champion.
It's a brave thing to do. I mean, after Gunther's performance against pretty much everyone he's ever been in the ring with, it's not surprising, though. CM Punk is feeling himself. He out-toughed Drew McIntyre at Bash in Berlin, one of the most brutally designed matchups possible, a strap match, and now he wants to take himself back to the top of the world.
He is on top of the world.
Oh, but he just got taken down! That is Drew McIntyre in a hoodie!
You gloat too much in this game. Drew McIntyre clearly not ready to put CM Punk in the rear view mirror.
He's on top of him.
Oh my, this is brutal.
This is brutal.
Wait, wait, Wade Barrett is getting involved here. He's been a longtime friend with Drew McIntyre. He's warned him before, admonishing him, advising him not to get suspended, to consider his career and his future. Meanwhile, CM Punk is badly damaged on the announce table after celebrating with the fans here in Denver.
And he's gone with Claymore! You gotta be kidding me! He just broke through Wade's restraint and claymored CM Punk. Wade tried to talk sense into him. 48 hours ago, it was Punk who finished Drew in a strap match. He comes here and says he's in the rearview mirror. He calls out Gunther, and that's how McIntyre responds.
Tosses him into the ring. Wade's still trying to get his attention, trying to calm down the rage within Drew McIntyre. This is going too far.
Guys, Drew is gone. I don't know who you've got back there. You're going to have to send all of them.
Wade, the look in his eyes when he broke through to get to him on that claymore here on our table.
Joe, there's nothing I can do. Something has gone wrong in the mind of McIntyre. I can't stop this.
That would be it.
And CM Punk looks like he's in no position to defend himself. The sneak attack, the claymore kick, the first. Now he's bashing him. He's kicking him in the head.
Send everyone you've got.
You can hear him saying, I want that bracelet back. The sheer brutality.
Let him do what he's gonna do.
The beloved bracelet that CM Punk worked so hard to regain in Berlin is now back on the wrist of his most bitter rival in the most heated rivalry that the industry has seen this calendar year.
That's what Drew needs. Let him have it and get Drew out of here.
Punk needs medical attention right now, and safety is what he needs. The names of his wife, AJ, and his beloved dog, Larry, on that bracelet. That was just snapped in half, and the beads are strewn all over the ring.
It's symbolic of everything CM Punk holds dear, i.e. his family.
Drew McIntyre has crossed the line that we have yet to see.
And he's shoving the beads in Punk's mouth. They have to stop him.
They can't stop it, Joe. That's the problem.
Another claymore. Wait, this has gone far too far.
Don't look at me. There's nothing I can do. There's nothing these guys
here,
can do.
Here come officials. Here comes Adam Pearce. And he's beating him in the head again.
I've just not seen, I've known Drew 20 years. I've not seen this side of him before. Punk thought this was over.
Punk had Drew in the rearview mirror. It was on to Gunther. Drew came out from under the ring, the black hoodie, and said, no, I'm not done with you at all. And in a year of brutal attacks, you remember what happened in the garage door in Chicago. This surpasses all of them between these two.
Mercifully.
They're waving for medical attention for Punk.
Yeah, mercifully, it looks like McIntyre is done. Get him the hell out of him.
Now here comes the EMT, the stretcher, the spinal board, as Punk is badly damaged here in